Hey guys, welcome back. So today's video is super exciting because we are starting Halloween week. Now, I do not have any sort of like fancy kitchen name for it. Maybe I will next year, but this year it's just Halloween week. So every day for the next 7 days, I will be uploading a video all about a true crime story that happened on Halloween. I'm not uploading these in any particular order or anything like that. It's just a couple of cases that I came across that I was like, I'm gonna need to talk about that. So let's just go ahead and dive right in to today's story, which I do feel the need to put a disclaimer in that this story is about crimes against children, so nothing like sexual or anything, just talking about children. So if you have like a really adverse reaction to hearing about crimes against children, then this might not be the video for you. But yeah, so with that out of the way, let's just go ahead and dive into the case of Nima Louise Carter. So if at any point you see me looking down, that is because my notes are in front of me. I do not retain large pieces of information easily and remember like details, so I do have to write out all of my notes and actually script these videos, which is also why I end up saying and a lot, and it's not because I'm high. Thank you very much. Got a couple of those. Did not appreciate it. So if you see me looking down, I'm just looking at my notes here. So Nima Louise Carter was born on March 23rd, 1976 to Rose and George Carter. Rose and George put Nima to bed Halloween night 1977. At some point in the night, they did report hearing her cry, but like a lot of parents, they hoped that if they left her alone, she would quiet down and learn to self-soothe. So that's what they did. They did not go and check on her when she started crying. She was just 19 months old when she disappeared from her home in Lawton, Oklahoma. She was found just 1 month later inside of an abandoned house just a few blocks away from her home. She had been placed inside of a fridge in that house and had died of asphyxiation. So unlike in a lot of these cases, police actually zeroed in on a suspect very, very quickly, a neighborhood babysitter of Jackie Robodeau. She was 18 years old when Nima disappeared, and she had been regularly babysitting for the Carters for quite a while. Her name actually jumped out at investigators as soon as they started in on this case because they recognized it from another abduction and murder case that happened just 1 year earlier in Lawton, Oklahoma. Twin 3-year-old girls, Mary Elizabeth and Augustine, or Tina as they called her, Carpitcher, were lured from their grandmother's house while they were watching TV. The abductor unlocked the front door, knew how to unlock the front door, and lured the girls out of the house in broad daylight. Much later, a witness actually came forward saying that she had seen the girls being dragged down the sidewalk away from her grandmother's house by their wrists, and that they were clearly struggling to get away from their abductor, but she felt that she shouldn't intervene, that it wasn't her place to intervene in something that she didn't understand, so she did nothing. The girls were found 2 days later in a fridge in an abandoned home nearby. Unfortunately, Mary Elizabeth succumbed to the lack of air inside of the fridge, but Tina was able to find a small hole that she was able to breathe out of until a group of neighborhood kids heard her crying for help and released her. When the neighborhood girls asked Tina who had put her inside of the fridge, she said Jackie Boo, which is the nickname for her babysitter, Jackie Robodeau. It's a great time for my trash people to show up. Even with this eyewitness testimony of Tina clearly saying that Jackie was the one that put her inside of the fridge, Jackie wouldn't stand trial for another 3 years for the murder of Mary Elizabeth. Meaning, of course, that Rose and George Carter never knew that they hired a murderer to watch after their child, Nima. Even now, 42 years after the murder of Nima Louise Carter, the only physical evidence that has ever been found in her case was her body. The Carter home was still locked up tight from the inside. The windows in Nima's bedroom were completely shut and locked, and none of the exit windows or doors showed any sign of a forced entry. This fact actually led the investigators to first suspect the parents. However, they were quickly ruled out after polygraphs showed that they had absolutely no involvement in their child's death. They do still believe, however, that the abductor was inside the house when Nima was put to bed that fateful Halloween night. Investigators believe she might have actually been hiding in Nima's closet. She was then carried out of the house. The abductor was so brave as to even walk past her sleeping parents in the living room holding their daughter. One odd thing that kept popping up in every article that I read about this case was the fact that just 2 months before Nima's abduction, the Carter home was vandalized and their family dog was actually poisoned. Police and George Carter always believed that the person that vandalized their home and killed their dog had intimate knowledge of their home and knew things about the family that only close people would have known. However, no one ever took the blame for this vandalism and death of the family dog, so the Carters just cleaned up the mess and carried on with regular life. Police had absolutely no evidence tying Jackie Robideau to the murder of Nima Louise Carter and called the case against her circumstantial at best. So unfortunately, she would never stand trial for her possible involvement in Nima's murder. However, she did eventually stand trial for the murder of Mary Elizabeth Carpitcher. Her brave twin sister, Augustine, took the stand as the prosecution's key witness and told everyone in that courtroom that Jackie Robideau was the one that put her and her sister inside of that fridge. The first trial ended in a mistrial, but finally justice was served when the judge in her second trial sentenced Jackie to life in prison. She died in her jail cell in 2005 at the age of 46. Now I know that there is basically no information in this case, and unfortunately I do have to believe that that fact is due to the fact that all of the children in this case were Indian American children. They were not reported on. There were no massive searches. And unfortunately, due to the police absolutely fumbling, in my opinion, the start of the Carpitcher case, Nima Louise Carter was put in a situation where she was at risk. I do think, though, that it is worth mentioning that George Carter still to this day does not believe that Jackie was capable of hurting his daughter. While he does believe that the person that did these awful crimes against Nima and vandalizing their home did need intimate knowledge of their home, Nima was so fond of Jackie that he just doesn't see how she could have done it. He said that Nima used to run to Jackie every time she saw her, and that she would just beam from ear to ear and got so excited when Jackie was around. Nima's grandmother, however, fully disagrees with this. She says Jackie was always weird, whatever that means. Unfortunately, Rose Carter passed away before she could ever find any sort of justice for her daughter. Now, if I missed any information, which is highly possible, the internet is a deep, deep ocean full of information for these cases, please leave anything I might have missed in a nice way in the comments down below. I always want to make sure that these cases are as accurate as possible. If you liked today's video, please consider hitting the subscribe button and sticking around for the rest of Halloween week. And if you have any case suggestions for future true crime videos, please leave them down below. I'm always willing to look into a new case.